The LowMesh Pocket S. It's a solar, all-in-one, ready-to-go, out-of-the-box, and sub-$100 price point Meshtastic node. There's a lot to love here, and a few things to keep in mind. So long as you know what you're in for, this is a very nice little node for your collection. Today we're taking a look at the new Pocket S solar node, which is the first of an all-new LowMesh series of products available exclusively at Rockland. The Pocket S is the first solar-based, no assembly required Meshtastic node that isn't something off of Etsy. The Pocket S is a take out of the box and go, and it's actually quite competitive even with DIY solar nodes. What is LowMesh? Before we talk about the device, a quick word about the LowMesh brand. Currently, it is exclusively sold at Rockland, but not made by Rockland. So this means that it is currently just a US-focused brand, as there are no international resellers. Yet. At CES 2025, Rockland had a booth and was showing off four LowMesh devices. This includes the Pocket S we're looking at today, along with the Tracker E, Tracker C, and Mag Mini, the last three of which are listed as coming soon on Rockland's site. Before we take this apart and get into the specs, let's take a look at the exterior. The first and most obvious feature is the solar panel on top. On this side, we have the cap for an external antenna, which we will revisit once we're on the inside. On this side, we have a lanyard hole. The Pocket S comes with a carabiner lanyard, as seen on the website. I chose to replace it with this monofilament that you can barely see on film, aka fishing line, partially because it looks better on film and partially because it's a little bit sneakier. Over here, we have the power switch, we have the reset button, we have a USB-C port. This is the light to indicate that there is activity going on, and this is the charging light, so that only turns on when there is solar. On the back side, we have a little opening here for the buzzer, so it's easier to hear. And finally, it's a little bit hard to see what exactly this is, but it is a hole for a quarter 20. So you can mount this on top of a tripod or something similar. For the next version, I have to say I would like to see some sort of heat set insert because a plastic is not going to last too many uses. All right, let's run through some of the most critical specs for this node while we take it apart. The retail price is $99 as of the publication of this video, and as you have seen in the video, it is ready to go out of the box. For the connector, we have USB-C as we saw externally. The SoC is a rack 4630 here, which means it's an NRF52 based SIPS power, which is what you would hope for on a solar powered node, and a LoRa SX1262, which is fairly standard as far as LoRa nodes go. There is no GPS, although the UART pins are broken out here, so it is theoretically possible. The antenna is integrated. It's hard to tell, but it's right up here on the PCB. As noted, this has the capability for an external antenna here. This hookup here, it comes with an SMA connector in the bag or in the box. And you just need to change a little soldering point here and solder up the SMA, and you have an external antenna. There's obviously no display. Again, better for the battery life. Speaking of battery, we have a 2000 milliamp hour integrated battery, and the solar panel is 0.8 watts, which we're going to take this out altogether. And this is a little shim insert. You can see we have the Sino Space 0.8 watt, 6.6 volt solar panel with these little pads here that hook up to the pogo pins on the back of this circuit board, which I have to say I've never seen this design before. Maybe I just haven't taken apart a lot of solar powered things, but it's a very cool concept. I'm going to put that back inside and put that back down. This tray is mostly to keep the battery and circuit board in place. Finally, we have a buzzer, a real-time clock in here to assist with the fact that there is no GPS. Oh, We're getting traffic right now as we speak. And a BME 280, which is somewhere down in here. Ah, there it is. For a temperature, pressure, and humidity sensor. It's a pretty accurate little device. So I'm a big fan of having the environmental data included. Finally, this case is printed in a high temperature resistant edition of PETG. So it should not melt if put on a car dash. But again, anything 3D printed, you want to be careful with extremely high temperatures. Now that we've taken the unit apart and gone for a deeper dive, let's answer one of the most important questions about any Meshtastic radio. What would someone use this node for? The Rockland sales material shows that the Pocket S is clearly targeting the outdoor or camping enthusiast. I would also add that anyone in the prepper category might be interested as well. In short, this node is great for someone who wants a Meshtastic node and doesn't want to worry about needing to recharge the batteries frequently. Anyone who's going to be off the grid for longer than a few days. Even for events such as Burning Man, this node could be quite useful. I've run a few tests of the solar panel and battery. The first chart shown, the dark blue line being the battery level, is a slow burn down while sitting in my office window. This is really the worst option for solar charging. It hardly counts as getting a charge at all. Importantly, you can see what we've got here is about 5 days of runtime shown and around only 10% battery loss during that time. The second test is the Pocket S outside, hanging vertically from my fence facing west. It received a reasonable amount of sunlight each afternoon. This was much better, but still not what you call a best case scenario. It's a charge much more like what you'd see in the real world, not perfectly aligned, not dawn to dusk charging. But importantly, following the dark blue line on the graph again, you can see by the end of each day, the charge has jumped approximately 10%. This is more than enough for a single day of charging to run the Pocket S for a few more days. The first thing that came to mind while tinkering with the Pocket S is that for a radio designed to be used outdoors, it is not that waterproof. I did accidentally leave it outside for an evening of light rain, and the unit was not ruined, but I cannot recommend repeating that experiment. If there is a V2 of the Pocket S, I'd like to see more effort put into at least making the node water resistant, like a tighter sealing case and conformal coating. That being said, the lack of waterproofing is really a trivial problem to solve. A 3-cent sandwich bag is all you need, and it will handily deal with the water. Maybe upgrade the setup with a desk and packet too while you're at it. If you're a fan of node abuse, hit the subscribe button. There's more where that came from. For a little nicer option, I found a Pelican phone pouch, extra large size, that allows the Pocket S to charge and be totally waterproof. See, as promised, more node abuse. If it can dodge a hose, it can dodge some rain. Or you could just live in California where we're in drought 19 of 20 years. To wrap things up, if you want an inexpensive Meshtastic node for your campsite, this is actually a very price competitive option. It has been designed to run for quite a long time, so you can leave it somewhere safely out of the rain and sun for multiple days. The option for an external antenna provides a chance for significantly improved reception should you want this to be a base station. While this will not be my everyday carry, it's certainly versatile enough to find itself a lot of niche use cases. If there are other devices you'd like to see an overview of, let me know in the comments. Otherwise, you'll find the LowMesh Pocket S on Rockland's site, link in the description, and be sure to check out some of our other Meshtastic content, linked on the left.